guys, so we are going to do this video about being black in Sweden. So I did a video earlier on my channel speaking about my experience as a black person in Sweden, and I have a couple of friends here who are going to be talking about their experience. So you guys stay tuned. I'm going to start off with her. Everybody's going to introduce themselves. What's your name?
I'm Mishii.
Yeah.
Yeah, Francesco.
By the way, he has a YouTube channel.
Yeah, I have a YouTube channel. Francesco is the name of my YouTube.
Yeah. And you too, you have a YouTube channel, right?
Mishii.
Yes, you guys can go follow her. I'll take your link so that you know I'll link it up.
Subscribe.
But you can Richie.
Yeah.
On YouTube.
And you already know it's your boy Saint Mark Ronaldo. Pop 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 pop.
Bruh.
Oh. Adam, you feel me already know the
vibe. So. So you guys, let's get started and get right into the video.
Yeah, hello? Who's this? Hey, let me call you back. Let me call you back.
I'm looking for some kamani.
Some kamani.
Some kamani. Next week, I'm expecting some kamani.
Some kamani.
Some kamani.
Just one thing though, before we get into the video, subscribe to the channel and also make sure you watch this video from the beginning to the end, because it will help the YouTube algorithm, will push it out there to more people to watch it, and also like it, give it a huge thumbs up, and yeah, also it will help with my watch time. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you in my next one. No, thank you guys so much, and let's get right into the video.
Maybe you can say it in English and she'll just translate.
Yeah, you can. I can ask you in English. You can. Okay. So first of all, where do you come from?
I come from Uganda. But I'm born and raised in Sweden.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, I don't want the attention to be on you too much, because you know. Okay, maybe I can ask other people as well.
Yeah.
Okay. Where do you come from?
Jag kommer från Nigeria. Jag var född och uppväxt i Italien, och nu är jag här i Sverige.
Yes. What about you?
Jag är från Congo. Jag kom hit 2014.
Yeah, okay. Congolese. You speak Lingala?
Yes.
Okay, nice. Yeah, I already know where he comes from. That's my
What's
brother.
What's that supposed to mean, though? I'm from Uganda, though. I'm from them ends. I'm from Uganda, Kampala. I came to Sweden in 2016. On my own, by the way.
Okay. We see.
That's it all you need to know. If you need to know more, you're gonna need to subscribe to my YouTube channel.
Okay, what about you?
Afro Latino, you to sabe. My mom's white. My dad's African and Latino.
Yeah. Okay, nice to meet you all. Okay, let's get right into the questions.
Yeah, ma'am.
How does it feel like living in Sweden?
Som en svart person.
Yeah, like a black person.
Jag känner typ att det är different. Alltså, det är annorlunda exempelvis när man går och handlar. Man går och liksom koppar och sånt och köper smink. Där hittar du knappast färger för liksom mörkhyade dark skin people. För att det är liksom oftast att majoriteten alltså är vita människor, så de oftast gör smink till ljushyade människor. Och så prioriterar de inte de människor som är kanske i våra mörka, alltså med mörkare hy. Som jag exempelvis, dark skin.
Yeah.
Så det är lite jobbigt där. Speciellt om du är svart. Hur är det att vara svart i Sverige? Det förekommer mycket rasism bland annat. Och från vita människor. Men det är ofta strukturell rasism i samhället som finns. Så det är lite mer indirekt än vad det är direkt rasism. Men jag kan även uppleva liksom att folk, de tänker liksom wow, oj, du kan jättebra svenska. Liksom, jag är född i Sverige, obviously. Jag borde kunna prata flytande svenska, så jag vet inte liksom vad de menar med det. Men ja, ibland vissa sådär skeva saker säger de och blir lite såhär, jättekonstigt.
Konstigt, ja.
Ja, precis.
Okay. Bizarre. Ja, okej. On to you.
Yes.
How does it feel like living in Sweden as a black person?
Det känns helt annorlunda jämfört med, du vet, jag bodde i Italien innan jag flyttade till Sverige. Så det är helt annorlunda. Folket här i Sverige, de är mer så här sina egna vibe. Alltså Italien, det är annorlunda, för Italien alla människor var öppna, alla så här friendly. Men här i Sverige känns som folket är så här, alltså de mind their business.
Det är i Italien.
Men alltså jag har inte gått igenom rasism i Italien i alla fall.
Nej.
För alltså det där jag bodde, det var ändå så här blandade folk, förstår du? Det var inte bara italienare.
Precis.
Men här i Sverige har inte heller gått igenom så mycket rasism grej, men Alltså det finns rasister överallt så...
Men jag kan också känna det så här, att... vad är det? Ska jag säga nu igen. Att som svart person så kan man ofta se oss som jätteloud people, jättehögljudda och sånt, att vi skriker och sånt. Men egentligen det är bara så att vi pratar och det är så här vi pratar. Men för dem, eftersom de svenska är så tysta, så blir det som att vi är jätteloud.
Like we are ghetto.
Ja, eller jätteghetto. Så det är också att folk har alltså, prejudice, alltså fördomar om oss, vet du det, svarta människor, att vi är jättehögljudda. Alltså egentligen det är bara egentligen de som är jättetysta. Så att vi blir jättehögljudda. Okej, vi kan vara lite högljudda och aggressiva. Men oftast folk dömer oss direkt att she's black, she's dark skin, she's aggressive. Hon är arg.
Kriminell.
Eller att hon...
drug dealer. Exakt, precis.
Det är verkligen såhär, jump into conclusions. Och det är väldigt synd att det är så här i samhället.
Okej, on to you sir. How does it feel like living in Sweden as a black person?
Ja du, det känns... Alltså det är inte... Det känns normalt, men samtidigt inte, för det kommer alltid förekomma rasismgrejer. Och jag har varit med om det några gånger, eller? Exakt. Men ändå, helt ärligt, Sverige ändå, det är bland de där länderna som jag skulle säga att någon svart kom bo här. Samtidigt, alltså, det finns ändå folk som är rasister hit och dit, men ändå...
Ändå Sverige är faktiskt ett bra land.
Ja, jag förstår du. Som med hon som Mishii. Det är mer så indirekt, alltså det är inte direkt.
Exakt. Yeah.
Fast det har hänt med direkt, men det är inte så många gånger. Men indirekt, man vet redan. Någon tycker sådär om det, så man är van, man vet redan hur allting ligger. Men samtidigt, det känns både normalt men inte. Men ändå, det är lite...
Och to you sir, Mr. Ronald Sentmark. How does it feel like living in Sweden as a black person?
Well, it feels tough, to be honest. Most especially if you don't, if you cannot speak too much Swedish and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And most of the people, they have to ask me more than once about my age. Even if I tell them like I'm 21, they don't believe it. They'd be like, okay, you're probably 30 in Africa with like...
Because you're tall, maybe.
Probably. No, that could be the case. But according to them, they said like all black people, they cut their age when they come to Sweden. That's something I was like, okay, that's racist and stuff like that. And then, things happen, like, you know, as well. Like, when we go to, like, a shop, like, a supermarket. Like, if, let's say, it's a bunch of black people going to a supermarket, you're definitely going to call, like, the security guards on you. And they're all going to be, like, literally following you, wherever you're going and stuff like that. You know? And then, some other stuff happened, but I don't think I can talk about it without the permission of everybody, because it wasn't only me who was experiencing it. He was there. Ape was there and Kevin was also there, like some weird shit happened to us when you are coming from other plan.
Was it like a racist encounter you had?
Like... I wouldn't say racist, it was much more like, you know, brutality. I definitely feel like this was incited due to, like, you know, due to racism. And if I was of a different color, I wouldn't have experienced this stuff, you know. I was with my friends and it's my birthday, you know, and we're from chilling and we're going home. And then some of us didn't have the bus card and they told us to leave the station, okay? And we left the station. We followed you compared to their orders. We were literally outside of the station. They started pushing us and stuff like that.
Oh, that's crazy.
I know. And then they were being rude basically, but I mean, it is what it is.
All right, I have another question. What are the challenges you faced in Sweden as a black person? Maybe she's busy. I
can take that first.
You can
it's
go
hard to get a job when you're a black person. Trust me. I have a perfect CV. And I have friends who don't have shit, but because they have, like, you know, they don't have like a black name, so like, you know, after now, if you don't have, like, you know, if you don't have connections, it doesn't matter how good your CV is. You're not going to get a job.
Det handlar inte om utbildning eller någonting sånt. Alltså, hur länge du har pluggat. Det är jättesvårt för jobb. Min pappa, han har pluggat KTH. Det Kungliga Tekniska Högskolan. I flera år. Han pluggade industriell ekonomi. Men det tog jättemånga år för honom att få jobb. Så han var ju arbetslös ett tag. Tills han till slut fick ett jobb. Så it's hard. Alltså, det är mer liksom. Om du har utbildning, du har pluggat flera år. Jätteavancerade liksom, program. Master, nej, det doesn't matter. Så det är väldigt synd att det verkligen har blivit så att vi kämpar jättemycket för att sen inte bli belönade för det hårda arbetet vi har lagt på liksom, skolan och så.
100%.
Okay, so what about you? What are the challenges?
För mig är det också exakt samma sak det med Saint Mark, eller det Saint Mark sa med jobb och så. Mm. Jag har varit arbetslös i snart, jo faktiskt över ett år.
Oh
men
my God.
Jag har jättebra CV. Jag har sökt jobb, men de tackar alltid nej.
Och du pratar väldigt bra svenska.
Ja, exakt, förstår du? Men, men ändå så vill jag inte ta in mig. Men nu till slut, Gud har gjort det för mig. Han har gett mig jobb. Men det var inte på grund av, men vänta, det var inte på grund av att jag sökte jobbet.
Mm.
Jag hade kontakter, alltså så här, en vän som fixade åt mig.
Mm.
Det känns som det är det enda sättet för oss svarta.
Att få jobb.
Inte oss svarta, men alltså vissa och få jobb.
Yeah.
Men jag känner typ att i Sverige också, det finns challenge, exempelvis när utmaning, ja, när exempelvis när man söker jobb, ofta exempelvis Mellanöstern, de anställer sig själva, vilket gör att det ger dem kontakter, förstår jag menar. Men när det kommer till black people, vi har inte chansen att kunna bygga upp oss som chefer, att kunna anställa more black people, alltså i företaget, förstår jag menar. Så det blir inte heller så många alltså, jobb till svarta människor.
Mm.
För att vi får aldrig chansen att kunna bli chefer för att kunna anställa sen more black people.
Mm.
Sen. Och det är där som är väldigt synd att att vi inte kan göra något åt det, för att det är så, det är strukturell racism i Sverige, och det är det som gör att vi kommer aldrig kunna vara övervita eller jämt heller.
That's bad. Okay, what about you?
Det är samma som de faktiskt, jobbet och allt det där, det är svårt.
Samma,
all right.
Another, another arbetslös.
Ja, faktiskt.
Another thing, like, another challenge that I wouldn't say only black people experience this. I would be like most of the foreigners experience this.
Mm.
They have a hard time to keep up with the pace of those who already like, you know, speak Swedish and stuff like that. Most especially after you have been like qualified to go to a gymnasium. You're going to have like a different grading system, but you're not going to get extra help to get the good grades. Basically, the only thing that you have like, you know, that's a little bit easier, it's Swedish. Math, you're going to still do math as everybody else. I feel like, for me specifically, like, I'm extremely smart. I'm not even bragging.
Okay.
So it's not too much for me, but I can tell, like, you know, this is some, this is not the way it's supposed to be, like, something, you know.
Yeah.
Has to be done about that, like, maybe they get, like, some sort of way they make it easier for the foreigners to be able to, like, you know, to also study. Because people literally give up on school because of this same whatever reason, yeah? They be like, I'm not gonna be even successful at school after all. They end up, like, maybe, like, becoming
settling for less.
Exactly, settling for less, basically, yeah.
Okay, so another thing that I'm thinking of right now, that do you guys ever feel like you had to change your names because it would benefit you to get a job?
Yes, I
yes, 100%.
Jag använde my like Swedish jag använde mitt mellannamn, which is Marika. Marika är ett svenskt
namn.
Alltså det heter ju andra namn,
men
mina föräldrar tyckte inte det var svenskt, men alltså det är svenskt, ganska många svenskar heter så. Så jag brukar heta så på min mail eller typ så här. Jag har det, alltså Mishii, Marika, Marumba eller någonting sånt, för att annars så kommer bara döma liksom bild på, eller så har jag bild. För att, liksom, alltså, för att det känns som att om jag inte har bild, då dömer de mig direkt bara på, och så blir det inte så att jag får chansen att gå på en intervju.
Fast bild är ju värre typ.
Nej, bild är inte värre.
De ser ju svart också.
Nej, för, nej folk, det, folk tycker det är bättre när man har bild.
Jag har aldrig bild
på CV. Nej, Shema, hon är själv rekryterad, hon
anser själv.
Om du har bild.
Jag får inte jobb när jag har bild.
Ja, men tjejer oftast är det bättre än att ha bild om man är invandrare.
Mm.
Det är faktiskt sant. För du kan också säga att hon är kanske vänlig, hon ler ju på bilden. Ja, så därför att du kan bilda olika uppfattningar om liksom, tjejen då på bilden. Liksom, led till intervju. Så ja.
Okay, so what about you guys? Have you ever felt like you needed to change your name because it will raise your chances of getting a job?
Definitely.
Jag tänkte på det massa gånger, men alltså min mellannamn är inte, jag har inget så här. Det finns ju, alltså min mellannamn är inte bättre än min förnamn. Så jag heter Akin Bamidele mellannamn. Det skulle göra allting värre bara. Så jag bröstar bara vid första namn.
Vad är det för långt namn?
Visst är det inte? Att heter Akin Bamidele mellannamn.
Nu ska man veta.
Jag har sagt det. Akin Bamidele. Nej, du sa längre.
Jag sa Akin Bamidele. Okej.
On to the next one.
Jo, det är samma för mig. Mitt namn är ju, eller efternamn, det är Mbala. De kan inte uttala det, de säger Mbala. Jag säger Mbala, men det är bara, det blir bara så. Ibland bara man tänker, tänk om mitt namn var typ Berg. eller till Pontus, något sånt här.
Pontus!
Should I tell you guys something, yeah? Jag heter, and my name is Josephine. So it is actually a Swedish name.
Yeah,
Josephine.
So my grandfather named me after my auntie, who is late right now. Her name was Josephine, exactly. Flavia. So when I came to Sweden, they used to say that, oh, I changed my name because like Josephine is, because it's pronounced Josephine in Swedish. So everywhere I go, they used to think that I actually changed my name, but I never really changed my name. Like, that's my name. My grandfather has never moved out of Uganda. Like, he don't even know that it's a Swedish name. So, yeah, that was kind of crazy.
Yeah.
Okay, next question. Do you feel like there's diversity in Sweden? In a sense that... Diversity. Would you expect?
I've actually never seen a black lawyer in Sweden.
You never see a black lawyer?
I've been to many courts, and I'm telling you.
I'm the only black person in my whole school, and that doesn't come as a boomer. I mean, as I said, the school system is really tough, so very many people are going to end up, like, you know, giving up and settling for less than they can do because they cannot, like, you know, keep up with the schools, like, you know, school, like Swedish school system, which is only designed, like, you know, to favor those that are really good at Swedish and stuff like that. So it happens that I'm the only black person in the whole school. But as far as diversity is concerned, if you go out there, yes, you're gonna meet like different culture, people from different cultures out there and stuff like that. But in the real, like, you know, in the real community, like, let's say if you go to governmental, like, institutes and stuff like that, social and stuff like that, it's gonna be really rare to find, like, let's say a black person working at a bank.
Yeah.
Like, you know, stuff like that. It's really hard, like, you know, to see them, like, to get, like, a black teacher, like, to meet a black teacher. I've never seen a black doctor.
Yeah.
And I've been to very many doctors because I reserve health issues. So there comes a question, like, can I really be that big in Sweden?
Yeah.
Can I be a doctor? Can I be a lawyer and stuff like that?
That explains the reason why like most black people don't really go and study further. They just stop at the high school level. Do you think that's the reason why?
I mean, this in addition to the fact that many of them, they have issues from where they come from, their families to feed and stuff like that. You know, they always end up, like, you know, getting distracted and stuff like that. So it's part of the reasons, but I wouldn't say, like, you know, it's completely, like, you know, the only reason and stuff like that.
Okay, so what about you guys? Do you feel like there is diversity in Sweden? Who wants to go first?
Definitely.
Okay.
Som han sa också, i min skola, hur många svarta är vi? Två stycken svarta. Det är tufft att gå där. Alltså, man är bara different, man är annorlunda. Du ser bara på ett sätt, hur de pratar, det är bara... Alla kan gå, du har svenska, araber, du har alla de här. Men så fort du är där, man bara, du är svart, du är annorlunda. Och sen, fast jag har min företagsekonomislärare, hon är svart. Hon är det enda svart. Men ändå när jag och hon pratar, då folk ska hela tiden minstänka. Så här, hon är min mamma, hon ska så här. Jag vet inte vad, det blir bara konstigt hela tiden. Såklart Sverige är mångfald land, ute i samhället. Men samma som du kommer till riktiga stället, typ läkarna, advokater. De är få, det är få. Så i skolan, att vara det enda svarta, alltså det är tufft. Hur de snackar med det var different.
Okej. I think I'm going to go to the next question. Do you feel like with the movement, the Black Lives Matter movement has raised awareness? Do you feel like it has affected all this separation that we face in Sweden?
No.
Or like the jobs, getting a job, do you feel like it has helped people? Like different companies have started hiring black people and, you know, people of other races as well?
No. So for me, honestly, I feel like, yeah, the only thing they did is to bring, like, you know, what really happens to us to light, but this is something that people already had an idea about. Like, they already know this is happening, but they did not know, like, you know, how serious it was. They did not know that, like, for example, that what happened to, what's the name of this guy? George Floyd. They don't know that a guy could get nailed on, like, you know, for 7 fucking minutes until he died and stuff. Like, they did not know about such stuff. But they knew that people face racist things, and they weren't doing anything about it. And they got, like, all excited. Yeah, black people, like, black... Lives Matter movement, because people always gonna want to be part of these things, you know. People always
because
want
it's a trend. That,
yeah.
Yeah, they want to be part of something big and stuff like that. Mm. So they treat it like, as she said, yeah, as a fucking trend, yeah. Mm. Sorry for cursing, but yeah. With time, it just vanished like it wasn't nothing. And there was, like, you know, there wasn't so many, like, things that got, like, you know,
there was no further discussion.
Yeah, there wasn't so many, like, so many accomplishments that got really done by this movement and stuff like that.
Mm.
So, but that's what I think.
Okay, so what do you think about this movement, the Black Lives Movement? Because they had it in Stockholm, was it?
Yes, a very big one also.
Yeah.
Basically, as you took it at, det är bra att vi gjort det, men det känns som att många white people har bara varit med och stöttat oss bara för att det är en trend och bara för att liksom alla hoppar in på den här trenden, liksom, den här strömmen bara, de följer bara strömmen.
Mm.
Men det känns inte som att det är genuint, det känns inte som att det är genuint, att de verkligen menar, att de verkligen bryr sig, att svarta oskyldiga människor dör på grund av polisbrutalitet. Liksom. Och jag känner det är väldigt synd att det har blivit så att det är mer som en trend, för så fort det blev där, alltså mindre, färre personer dog av polis, alltså polisbrutalitet, så slutade folk dela liksom. Alltså de slutade dela, det var som att de brydde sig inte, det var en period och så slutade det liksom. Alltså Black Lives Matter, alltså det still matter, inte liksom bara för den period, bara för George Floyd dog.
Yeah.
Det är så många som dött innan, men så fort liksom att det behöver vara en till, så behöver det regeras ännu mer och regeras ännu mer och ännu mer, alltså så stoppas och så dös det ut liksom.
Yeah.
Så jag tycker det är liksom, det är väldigt synd och det känns som att jag vet inte riktigt vad man behöver göra för att påverka ännu mer.
Mm.
Med tanke på att ingen tar det mer så seriöst här. Med tanke på att de tycker att det finns inte polisbrutalitet här i Sverige. Men jag har gått igenom det.
Mm.
Och det var inte kul. Och ja, poliser, I don't like the police. Alltså, to be honest. Det var inte roligt.
Just, I feel like people just support, I mean, also the white folks, they support it because it was a trend.
Yeah.
You know, they have always known racism exist.
Mm.
But now I feel like they all just try to support because it's a trend.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Get me?
Yeah.
So, okay.
Rasism nu, det kommer aldrig förändras.
Mm.
Det som kommer göra nu, det är för folk har mobiler.
Mm.
Folk kommer filma hela tiden.
Och exakt.
Men själva rasism kommer inte förändras. Typ den här, när jag gick på den här grejen här i Stockholm, Black Lives Matter, helt ärlig. Alltså, när jag var där, jag förstod meningen med det, men det var inte så där jag själv lärde mig någonting. Jag bara var där för att jag såg nu George Floyd dog, men egentligen för mig själv. Varför fick du dit?
Det är sant, för tänk om vi svarta tänker så, de vita, de är så
här. What are they going to think, right? Yeah.
Folk gick bara dit den här rörelsen, bara för att liksom festa och dansa och se människor.
Mm.
Det var inte för the real purpose, alltså vilket var att stå upp för svarta människors liv och att oskyldiga svarta människor dör. Vilket är väldigt synd, för att då är det inte genuint och då, varför gör man den här rörelsen? Det var inte onödigt att bara bråka med polisen och sådana grejer för ingenting. Jag vet att vissa människor var för dedicated och verkligen vill göra det här och vill se en förändring, men det känns som ingen tar det seriöst, för det är just Sverige.
Ah.
Det är därför de tänker, varför ska ni göra protestera om det ändå inte sker i Sverige, men det sker faktiskt.
What actions should be taken to decrease racism?
Well, for me, I feel like, yeah, no matter how much the government does and stuff like that, it all begins with us, you know. It begins with us people, like, you know, everybody. It begins with everybody. I feel like this is more of an individual job than just like, you know, a job being done by the government itself.
Yeah.
Cause I feel like we need to stop with categorization that, yeah, all black people are rapists. All black people are
criminals.
Aggressives. Yeah, all black people this, like all Arab people, they do this. All Arab people, they're like, you know, they are gangsters. All Arab people, they're like, you know, all Muslim girls, they're like, you know, terrorists and stuff like that. We need to stop with that sorts of, like, you know, categorization and stuff like that, and we need to become much more tolerant, because we, like, you know, we are different, yet, you know, we differ from each other, but at the same time we are, like, you know, same people and stuff like that. We need to understand that I might love to do this, but that person is likely to not like to do that, and that person might be doing something I don't like. I just have to, as long as something's not hurting anybody, it's not breaking any law, I just have to, like, you know, live with it and stuff. You get me? We need to have, like, what I call tolerance and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I feel like with those two combined and other very many whatever solutions, we can, like, you know, finally maybe get someone in talks of, like, getting rid of racism itself and stuff like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, one thing that I've noticed is that the suburbs, you know, the fancy places like Tabby,
yeah,
that's where you barely see any immigrants.
Black people,
that's what,
yeah.
I mean,
not in the black,
like white people that are not white. Mm. Let's get this shit straight. Like, yeah. White, I don't know how y'all define white, mm. but in America, and for me, white is Caucasian, like mm. person from Europe, blonde hair, blue eyes,
yeah,
from European,
yeah, yeah.
So Latino, Middle Eastern, Asian, they're not white. So they won't, they still won't get treated as white people. And I wanted to say is that you don't see nothing but white people in these good areas, and that needs to go. Mm. That needs to go, you know? And those people that grow up there, they think that they're better than everybody because only they live there.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Only they live the high life and all of that. And we're like, when people that are not white see, there's only white people that can live the high life and shit, they mm. just give up on it. They're like, I
yeah.
That's why a lot of black people, when they get rich, when they get famous, they wear a lot of diamonds and shit. Mm. They live the high life, they get flashy, because they want to show that, black people can do this too. We can also live high, we can yeah. also eat lobster, we can do this and that, you know what I'm saying? So it's not just about being flashy or whatever, it has a meaning behind it.
Yeah.
And when I see, like, personally, when I see, like, black people wearing jewelry like that, like, living the high
buying fancy cars, suburbs,
it motivates me
yeah.
to see that. Yeah, you know, like, people that are not white can also live the high life. Mm. You know, when I see my Latino and black brothers succeed and all of that, when I see, like, a bunch of, like, rich people, smart people, like, and it's also one thing that I noticed is that a lot of things that they teach in school
mm.
is very inaccurate. That mm. needs to go.
Mm.
Like, they do a lot of, like, generalization. Like, for example, you got, like, Moroccans, right?
Mm.
You got Moroccans and stuff like that. In school, they teach you that they're Arabs and shit.
Mm.
But that is really not true, because majority of Moroccans are either black or mixed, you know? And genetically, they have nothing to do with Arabs. You know what I'm saying?
Mm.
And that's just, like, false information. And this, like, it makes young kids, it takes their identity away, you know? Mm. It makes them claim something that they're not, because mm. they learn in school that they're Arabs, mm. they're not Africans, but they still look African, they have flat noses, big lips, African hair, they're brown and shit.
Yeah.
But that's also a way to take away credit from the black people.
Yeah.
You see, because the northern part of Africa, they have enslaved white people
mm.
in Spain. They mm. have conquered Spain. And that is the reason why there are white people and mixed people in northern Africa. It's because they got married to these white slaves.
Mm.
And that's the thing they don't want to tell you about. They don't want to admit the fact that the white people also were slaves. Or the white people, like, these black people achieved a lot of stuff. They had chemistry at that time.
Mm.
And it's called the Moorish history. If you see, they still got those Moorish, like history, like, mosques
mm.
and buildings there. Los Moros, they call them in Spanish. And it's like, when they came, the European people, they were dying of diseases and stuff, you know, because mm. they didn't take showers. They didn't know that
you could take die, a shower.
That you could die if you're not clean. That you could mm. get diseases. And these Moorish people, they came with soap. They had lights on the streets of Spain
mm.
way before that mm. white man. I don't know what his name was that supposedly came up with the light bulbs. Mm. It wasn't him first. It was actually the Moorish people. And mm. that was streets. That was the lights on the streets in Spain hundreds of years before any white man did that shit. And so they rather call them Arabs
mm.
than call them black, just because they don't want the black people to be also have achieved stuff.
Yeah.
To have been smart, to be on that high level.
Mm.
So they rather just, you know what? We're going to just change the identity.
Mm.
So the people will still keep thinking low about the...
themselves.
The black people.
Mm.
And like in Northern Africa, I've lived in Northern Africa. I'm not originally Northern African or anything.
Mm.
But like, this was really the French colonization that did this shit. And I see a lot of people in Northern Africa, they be straightening their hairs, staying away from the suns. They got afros and stuff, you mm. know? Because they have this idea that being white is beautiful,
mm.
being this and that. And it's the colony that did that to them, you know?
Yeah.
And all of that, like, for example, me, my dad, he's a, what was it called? He used to be a really, like, white people praising person, you know?
Mm.
He always used to be like, white people are the most beautiful and this and that. And I had, like, afro, you know? So always when I was a kid, I was never allowed to grow out my hair, or I would have to make it straight, you know? Because he's like, that's ugly, you know?
Yeah.
You're light skinned, you're supposed to, you know? You have green eyes, you shouldn't ruin yourself and this and that. So that's why, like, now I got long hair and dreads and shit, because it's like my freedom. I'm like, yeah, you know what? I can't grow my hair. I like it this way and this and that, you feel me? But it is what it is. Like, one thing that I noticed, the only thing that we can really do against racism is mix. Because when people are more mixed, they can't hate nobody, you know?
Yeah.
But otherwise, racism is always going to exist. There ain't shit you can do about it. I'm just going to tell you straight up. We don't live in a sunshine, happy world.
Yeah.
We don't live in a fair world, and that's just a cold truth, you feel me? And the only thing that we can do is just get ready for it. Do our best to be motivated.
Because
you can't do shit in life without being motivated. You know? And understand that, yes, we can also succeed. You don't have to be white to succeed. You don't have to be white to be rich.
Yeah.
You know, and learn your true history. I'm telling y'all, be very criticize your sources of information. You know, get several sources and this and that before you claim anything, because
do your research,
because a lot of history is propaganda.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? A lot of history is fake history. You know what I'm saying? So just do your thing
And be yourself.
Hope for the best, be ready for the worst, because the worst is always going to be out there. You know, so that's just how it is.
Oh, thank you so much for your input. You are really a good speaker. Thank you. Hi guys, that was it for the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you had a lot to learn from this video. And you guys, you can leave your views down below, leave a comment, like this video, share it, and yeah, I'll see you in my next video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and become a flavor babe, okay? That's a period, okay? Bye.
Yeah, hello? Who's this? Let me call you back. Let me call you back.
I'm looking for some kamani. Next week I'm expecting some kamani.